grubbing on a little farm on the flat and windy plains. I've been listening to the hungry cattle bawl. I'm gonna pack my wife and kids, I'm gonna hit that western road. I'm gonna hit that Oregon Trail, it's coming fall. I'm gonna hit that Oregon Trail, it's coming fall. Hit that Oregon Trail, it's coming fall. Where the good rain falls aplenty and the crops and orchards grow. I'm gonna hit that Oregon Trail, it's coming fall.
So just to explain it to you, Alan, because I know you're not familiar. If you double click on your character's token, it will open your character sheet. Otherwise, there is a little people icon on the right hand side, and it has a list of all the characters, or should have. And you should be able to just double click on your character there as well to open it.
Is there a way to scroll the page around?
Oh, to move around the screen?
Yeah,
hold down right click, you can move around. There is the settings on the right-hand side. You can configure your own short keys. Your own binds and stuff like that.
Cool.
Or if you can't configure it, it'll tell you what they are at least. But yeah, your character sheet's all filled in. You're human, so yours is a lot less complicated. But if you've got your character token selected and then you use the macros at the bottom, they should all work fine, so you shouldn't need to really mess around with too much. And the only thing you'll need to do is on your gear, when you want to equip a weapon to use, you click on the weapon, it'll open up a window, and then there's a equip to selection, and you just equip it to your hands. And then when you do your attack macro, it'll use whatever weapon you have equipped to your hands. But you just need to remember unequip. When you're switching to weapons, which you might do because you have a couple. If anyone has like a rifle, I'll need to update this because I forgot, you should also have like a rifle butt in your inventory, and that's in case you want to hit somebody with the butt. So you would equip that as the weapon because the stats are different. Nice.
Means my grunt will have that.
Does my Tesla rifle have that?
Yeah, it's the same rifle butt as anything else.
Okay, because I am missing that item then.
Oh, okay. Wait, hang on. I'm just giving Dave his.
Yep, no worries.
You also have one for like punch, kick, headbutt, if that's what you're going to do. And obviously, as a raccoon, you've got
your
bite and stuff.
I've got that. Yeah. And I doubt my nail gun has a rifle butt.
Well, I mean, if you smacked somebody over the back of the head with a nail gun, it's the same thing.
Oh, okay, cool. Nice.
Oh snap. I did it. Get ready to be amazed. There we go.
What is that? Is that a measurement thing? Somebody's fucking baby stuff.
Moving my head back up on.
What the fuck?
That'll be Glim, he's the one going back and forth up there.
Oh, you mean the token that's sliding back and forth?
Yeah. Kind of like the monkey's actually throwing my token around.
I don't know how you do that with the thing.
You hold control and you move your mouse, and a little line will come out. Just click where you want to move around, and then you press space, and you do this. Amazing.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah. Turns out they have roll 20 rules too. That's
Okay, so before we go any further, does anyone have any questions about the stuff, the sheets and all the rest of it?
Let's see.
Yes, are you okay?
Yeah, are you? That's a great question.
I'm just tired.
I can't imagine so.
He did this for us, man. For us.
I definitely didn't do it for you.
Well, fuck you then.
I get easily distracted doing stuff, man.
That's fair.
Jesus Christ, this is way too many people. Okay, so the setting is basically Fallout in Oregon.
R-A-B-Y, because I fucked your sister, Norm.
Damn!
I cannot remember how many years after the apocalypse we said it was.
I don't remember.
But it's been long enough.
I think it was like
journals.
I think it was like 200 years. It wasn't that long.
Something like that. So I guess we begin Glorp and... is it Tristessa? Glorp and Tristessa will be taking the highway to Eugene. Or probably past Eugene, going to Portland in Oregon. When you hear like an explosion, very loud, in the distance, off to the east in the mountains. Glorp, who has a telescope, pulls it out and looks through and can see like, you know, rockfall landslide on the side of the mountain. And you both decide, I don't know why you're travelling together, but you both decide to investigate. You're not going to be able to take your big rig haul truck through the woods, up the river, towards the mountain. So do you want to hide it, or do you want to just like park it?
Well, I didn't install any self-destructive devices in that thing to prevent thieves, so I'm going to have to hide it.
I mean, you can also do what Mr. Pickles does. He takes the wheel, the steering wheel, off his vehicle when he leaves.
Yeah.
You know, that sounds like a trend that people should do, so then they install their steering wheel into someone else's car when they steal it.
Shut the fuck up. Do your own thing.
Glorp Glip. As a super mutant, you're pretty strong. I mean, do you want to try and haul your motorcycle through the woods and up the river to the mountain, or do you want to also hide it?
Wait, what happened?
Your motorcycle. Do you want to hide it by the highway, or do you want to drag it with you through the woods and up the mountain?
I want to ride it through the woods into battle.
So, I mean, you're, like, strong, so you can attempt this.
Nice.
So if you can make sure you've got your token selected, and then click the macro, which is the dice icon. I think it's Roll for Success, it's called. And it's going to be a muscle athletics roll with three bonus dice.
What am I clicking?
Your token, and then the macro for rolling, which is Roll for Success. It's got like dice icon. And it's going to be the muscle attribute, this athletic skill, and you'll have three bonus dice.
It's the button down at the bottom.
Yeah, it's on your hotbar. Yeah, that is fine. You're going to be able to grab your bike and just haul it with you with your super strength.
I don't even know where my dice roll went, dude.
It's in the chat log. Top right. Speech bubbles, double click on it, it'll open up the chat log.
Nice.
Damn it, so I can actually see this. Tristessa, sorry I interrupted you. You wanted to hide your hauler.
That's correct.
How are you hiding this massive haul truck thing?
Okay, so logically, there's a lot of trees and foliage and stuff, right?
Oh yeah.
So what we're just gonna do is drive it into the foliage and then just start pulling branches around it so it's hidden.
They're over by Eugene, right?
Well, they're coming off the highway.
Fair enough.
I can put us on the map. I haven't filled in all the locations we had because we had a lot of locations marked. I've just marked the ones where we are in Portland.
Oh, fair enough.
So, I mean, they're coming several miles through forest and upriver to get to you. Or in the direction where they had the explosion, which is where you are.
So where is Eugene on this map?
I think it's over here.
Yeah, it's
almost exactly.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's a lot of people that like us.
Yeah, we're great.
Oh, wonderful.
Right, I won't have you roll for hiding it. because I have no idea what skill wage is. But yes, you can drive it in there, pull branches and stuff over the back of it to hide it pretty decently. If you're taking it quite a ways into the forest, I mean, it's going to be very dense anyway.
Well, you have to remember, my truck has off-road handling.
Yes. Yeah, so you'll get quite a ways into the woods or up the river. It's just because the terrain is not going to be possible beyond a certain point. You'll get like halfway up the river before you encounter like a small village, and they have like a makeshift dam that they've set up, and you can see them like fishing as you approach. When they hear you guys coming, will tell your fortune for a little sweet tea. I need to turn off this playlist though, because nobody's actually listening to radio. Doing that shit? Where's all my young and sexy psychic freaks at?
What were you saying? You were cutting out.
Okay, so you guys
turn off the radio.
Yeah, you just will go like halfway up the river, and you just come across like a little village, very primitive looking, that's been set up, and they have a dam across the river, and they're fishing on it. When they hear the super mutant humping and scraping his motorcycle up the side of the hill, they will all like immediately like run off into the forest to flee. If you continue up the river, eventually you will come across a giant swamp or like a lake, and there's lots of chunks of giant frogs scattered all around, as well as floating in the water itself. From there, you will find tracks in the dirt. There's a party of people and a large vehicle that has managed to make its way even further east from here up the side of the mountain. Following that, you will come to, like, it looks as if the side of the mountain has been blown out, and there is a large circular entrance, like a cave. Immediately inside there, you find what was a closed, sealed vault door, which is now lying open. You will both know that it's rare to find a vault now that hasn't been opened, and there's usually many valuable things inside. So for Glorp and Tristessa, what do you want to do at that point?
Well, I guess the question is, why are we going out in this way?
Well, you're investigating the explosion sound.
Well, that explains the explosion, I suppose.
Wait, did you say there's treasures in the caves?
It is often said that there are treasures in the vaults, yes.
Interesting.
Yeah, but who went through first if they could blow a door off its hinges like that?
So the door has not been blown off its hinges. It is opened and on its hinges still. They've blown out the rock face that's covering it.
Someone who does that still. Who went in there before? And could they carry it all? Even then, I suppose the scrap metal is probably worth something to someone. Preserved metal, untouched by time, should be worth something. Sighs, checks the shotgun for a round in the chamber, and just goes in.
Why don't you, Dave, make me a roll for senses and notice?
That didn't work. Oh, I'm not on this map.
You should be able to just drag yourself out onto
it. I'm trying.
There you go. Yeah. As you're like prepping yourself before you go in, you like notice marks in the dirt. You can tell that there were, how many people do we have? Three people? Three humans, or human sized things we have. Feet, and then a smaller set of footprints that look like some kind of animal. You can see like scorch marks around the doorway, and you can see where a large section of copper wire has been ripped out.
Someone else already thought the same thing then. I will be going through the rooms, checking to see what hasn't been looted, and also checking the integrity of any steel in the vaults to be scrapped.
You can then roll a senses and scavenge roll. This is where we're going to have to roll a lot of dice. See if it'll let you roll a d15. Amazing. And then 2d6.
Alright. Rip.
Okay, you're going to find six antique plates.
Slash roll. 1d6?
1d6, yeah.
Or wait, 6d6?
1d6.
Okay, it sounded like you said 6d6 first. But also tell me, how good is the metal paneling of the vault? Can it be scrapped and can it be sold?
It could definitely be scrapped and sold, yes, with time.
Because my line of thinking is, this stuff has been preserved for hundreds of years, someone's going to pay good money for this.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of it rusted over, but in amongst it, there's so much of it quantity-wise that there's definitely going to be enough valuable stuff there to be worth your time to kind of peel it off.
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay, was that added to my inventory?
Yeah, I've got to do this every time, I think.
I'm sorry.
Okay, 4 antique plates, there you go. I'm going to have to figure out a quicker way to do that.
Jeez, you didn't even, like, put in all of the random items in all of the tables for scavenging?
There is over 450 items on the tables. That's why I didn't put them in.
I don't know, sounds lazy to me.
Do you want to die?
So as Triss is poking around and, you know, evaluating the panels of metal on the wall, Glorp, what are you doing? I'm assuming you've left your motorcycle outside the entrance.
Are we all entering the cave?
The vault, yes.
Oh. I guess we are in the cave.
So you're just following along?
Yeah.
You will hear over the tannoy system a crackling, hissing static that seems to ebb in just waves of intensity. Occasionally you can hear a sort of garbled voice, slightly feminine, but it's impossible to make out any of the words. As for the rest of you, I don't know how much you remember from the last session, but you had entered a lab with vats full of creatures and an electric ghost, which you managed to ground in a Faraday cage momentarily before it sank through the floor, mumbling about how it just wanted to help protect you and it had to feed them. So it sinks through the floor, and then what would you guys like to do?
You say it sinks to the floor.
I think if I recall correctly, I did hit it with my Tesla rifle and it healed it.
Yes, you'd shot it when it was like solidified and seemed to do some damage to it. And then when you blasted it with your Tesla weapon, it thanked you for helping it.
Right. So I immediately put away my fucking Tesla rifle. And I'm going to try to look over some of the machines as best I can. Just try to figure out what's useful or what might help us.
So Sensei's tech rule, I think.
Sure.
I mean, there's numerous consoles, panels, there's lots of like electronic readings, kind of analog like ticker numbers on the side of all these tubes that are like housing these creatures inside. So there's lots of like electronic components and stuff like that you could maybe use for something, but I'm not sure what you'd use immediately to help you.
No. Is there any other doors in this room then?
So there was an office where there was a skeleton.
Yeah.
Where you're staying.
I think we found a...
Yeah, you're filling out the recording tapes that he's listened to.
Yeah.
Which basically describes someone going missing in a lab accident and then their presence being felt before everyone got frazzled. You will also hear the sort of static hissing, cackling over the tannoy system.
But no other doors into this chamber?
No, this is like a big, huge lab room on its own.
Okay, fair enough.
You can go back out into the corridor. I think there was upstairs section where the other lab was. It's similar, but it wasn't filled with the bodies inside the tubes.
Yeah.
I'll go up there. Like, hey, you stay here.
Can I grab him as he volunteers and just throw him up there?
Well, you and Triss are still coming through like the entrance tunnel. You just wouldn't have been in the lab yet.
That'd be scary as hell. I'm like, what the heck?
Yeah, I knew that.
Until they do something that makes a noise, at least.
Yeah, climb up. I climb up there. I don't use the stairs. Stairs.
I mean, you need to use the stairs because that's how you get there. I mean, you could grab onto the banisters and pull yourself up that way.
Exactly. Exactly.
Like I said, the other lab is much the same, except that the tubes are empty. There's nothing in them at the moment.
There's absolutely nothing here. Sadness.
There are stairs that continue to go downwards. There will be a sign, if you can read, Imeda. Can you read?
Shit, what do I need for reading? Knowledge is power.
Well, I mean, if you can read, you can read. But I don't know if your ghoulish orangutan can read.
I mean, would that be under? I think I can read, I think. Well, for the hell of it, let's say no, so...
Right, okay. I mean, there are signs with arrows pointing up and down the stairs, but you don't know what they say, because you can't read.
Is there a no sign?
No, the signs are the same age as the surrounding environment.
Okay.
What about you, Goose? Because you're there.
Wait, Goose is talking?
Mitch had to leave, so Goose is currently the only human in there.
Wait, Mitch had to go?
She had to go.
I just go where Goose is.
So we have the raccoon scurrying around looking at screens and pressing buttons he probably shouldn't be pressing. What's Goose doing?
I saw Goose, words! Upstairs, words.
Alan, are you there?
Oh, he's typing.
Mr. Pickles, can you read?
Yeah.
Can Mr. Pickles read?
No, yeah. We established... No, actually, it was only... the only thing I said was that he didn't understand what communism was, so... My Tesla rifle has a communist symbol on it. I think Pickles can kinda read. While he's self-taught.
Yeah, he just can't really talk.
Yeah, I can't talk, but I can read. Oh, yeah, and right, because, that's how I sometimes communicate as well. It's been a while.
There's a skill for that, isn't there?
Well, it's a mutation that I have because I have a speech impediment.
Yeah, when he speaks, you have to roll to see if you understand him.
Yeah. You mentioned there's words, and Mr. Pickles kind of, like, pokes his head up, like, you know, where?
I pick him up and take him up there. Well, unless you want to walk.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to walk.
The sign says power plant and it points downwards.
I kind of hop in place and point at the door.
It's good or bad? I give you the thumbs up, down. Mm-hmm.
I shrug and I just point at the door.
All right, let's go. We're going in. Yeah, I'm going in. I'm going, How bad can it be?
Just see the base rebanger damage up here.
How bad can it be?
Do either of you have a light? Like a flashlight or something? I know Mr. Pickles can see in low light.
Yeah. That's about it. That's specifically why I don't carry a light source.
Is he super mutant see in the night? Or what am I? I'm not a super mutant.
How does it smell?
Fated.
Good.
Huh?
Fated.
Jesus, hold on. I'm asking the DM. What?
Fated. It's a very... Fated? Yeah, a damp rot kind of smell. I mean, you're not going to be able to smell it anyway. Because you smell just as bad. And no one around you is going to be able to smell it anyway because you smell just as bad. Okay, so I mean, given the faint light that you've had from the floor above, you can probably just about make out, you know, the ground is like shifting and moving and shimmering.
Hmm.
There is a light switch. Would you like to turn on the lights?
Should just say. Sure.
Yes, the large chamber you can see is covered in rad roaches. Or regular roaches, and then amongst them the occasional rad roach.
And I left the flamethrower in Gertie.
I hand him a Molotov cocktail because I had one in my pocket for some damn reason. Mmm.
So Triss and Glorp, as you are kind of like getting deeper and maybe like tallying up how much worth this scrap metal and electronics parts are going to be used, like something must trigger. You hear klaxons whirring for a second, and you can hear the gears grinding and mechanics whirring as the vault door closes behind you.
Just got one of those clenching your own teeth and going, well, mentally calculating just how fucked we are.
Then you start seeing like small sparks of electricity around the corners of the passageway and along the wiring, and they seem to like be moving in unison and then congregating together. What would you two like to do?
Go away from the electricity. How about that?
You run down a passageway and you briefly just sort of register a sign that's saying like kitchen and living quarters as you run past. Glorp, are you running with her?
Yes, but I'm ignoring those signs. I'll keep running.
Mr. Pickles and Omeda, you can hear doof, 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 like heavy footsteps echoing somewhere above.
The hell is that?
So are the rad roaches are just sort of scuttling about? They're not attacking us?
When the lights come on, they all scurry and spread and hide in the dark corners and vents.
Oh, good. That's good. So in that case, I will turn my attention away from the rad roaches and just kind of keep my eyes trained on the door behind us. Did we hear the vault door shut?
Maybe very faintly if you're listening, yeah.
Okay. So we're...
Oh, I tell you what, give me a senses notice roll. I think that's you fair. Roll it with a sixth sense because you're tearing. Yeah.
Wait, so do I just set 6 points or?
Yeah. Not for the attribute, okay, though, cool. For the skill.
Yeah.
Yeah, you definitely paired up. You could probably not only hear the super mutant footprints, you can probably hear a lighter set of footprints running as well.
Shit, I can read. But not that good. I'm sorry. I was like, fuck, can I read or not? I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, so Pickles naturally assumes that someone has come in after us and they shut the door, locked, sealing us in here. like a bunch of morons. I'm gonna try to keep my attention on the door. If Almeida's watching the door, then I will turn my attention to the rest of the room and try to see.
Okay, I'm watching the door. You watch the roaches.
Yeah. Well, I'm trying to find like anything noteworthy. This was supposed to be the power plant, basically. Yeah, so I'm just going to try to look for something that resembles a generator or reactor. Probably not something I should be poking around in.
I think you'd probably be able to see a big sign at the far end of the room that says reactor, and the arrow pointing to the door immediately below it.
Okay, I'll try to scuttle over towards the door and still keeping clear from the rad roaches, try to open up the door.
Okay, you want to roll nimbleness stealth. Yeah, you can get close to that door without anything interrupting you.
Sweet. I will attempt to finagle the door.
I mean, you can just put... It's kind of rusty. There's a lot of biological muck sort of rotting along the edges of the bottom of it, so you need to push it a bit. But you'll be able to get it to open.
Okay, I'll push it open.
There is a humming sound as you open the door, and you can see that strange-looking construction structure in front of you. It doesn't seem to be doing anything obvious, but by the sounds in this room, something is definitely happening. Oh, it is a lot warmer down here than it has been in the other rooms.
Okay, cool.
Glorp and Trissa and maybe Almeida, if you're further up as well, across the tannoy system, you can hear a cackling female voice, very staticky. And it's almost like it's whispering out. He's seen it. You found it.
Dinner time? That's what Glorp was saying about the voice, because he's going to eat her.
Yeah, Glorp rips the tiny speaker off the wall, and immediately the voice stops speaking out of the speaker.
I'm just Tressa's going to blink and slowly shake her head at that, and then just look back behind them for a moment, see if anything's following them.
It doesn't appear to be anything following you, but at the point that you are, with a sort of T-junction, one room going off to the kitchen, the other's going down to the living quarters, there's a foul, disgusting, gut-wrenching odour just seeping through the air here.
I resent that.
And it does seem to get worse as you approach the stairwell.
Like is it, like, what kind of bad smell is this? Is it, are we talking, like, corpse? Or are we talking someone took a shit?
What do you smell like, Almeida?
That's a great question, what he just asked, because I was trying to picture what kind of smell we talking about here. I don't know, man. A dumpster in a hot day? With a lot of garbage in it?
Like a very sweet, sickly, rotting kind of smell.
Yeah. I'm hot garbage. There you go. Well, yeah, it's musk-like odor.
Okay, so like a sweet musky kind of odor. But yeah, it is overpowering. Or as you get closer to the steps, it'll be more overpowering. I think from the corners of the walls, you can see like these large roaches just like scurrying along outwards and then back away again into the cracks.
Okay, well, if you're talking like hot garbage bad, that just sounds like the average unwashed wastelander.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that kind of smell a bit much stronger.
Yeah. A wastelander that washed with another that wastelander with no water.
For you, Almeida, the large heavy footsteps have stopped.
Those footsteps are getting close. I tell that to Mr. Pickles.
Well, he's down across the generator room. So yeah, I mean, you can shout down to him. If you do, you shout down to him.
Who's that?
You guys upstairs will hear the echoing shout.
I have a gun filled with ammo. State your business.
Does he sound anything like the weird, creepy lady who wanted to be eaten by Glorp?
Nope.
No, it's a very different place.
Shit, what did she say again so I can actually repeat that?
You want me to do the whole recite again?
No, what the lady said in the speaker.
Oh, she was like whispering, they've found it, he's found it.
Does anyone hear a lady speaking in a speaker?
What's her name again? Did she ever give her name?
No.
Oh, you mean that Sparky chick. Yeah? Why?
She's looking for it.
I think we found it.
Whoever you are. Hey, look, someone left the door up there open, and, I don't know about you, but I you know you're sitting on a treasure trove of scrap metal up here, right? Well, it would be if the door to the vault didn't slam shut behind me. And I'm not saying I did it, because I didn't.
Glorp, the speaker you pulled off the wall starts to, like, cackle and make a static noise despite being no longer connected to the rest of the system.
Ah, I'm gonna throw it.
Wait, it's making that sound in his belly?
Wow.
It's like a bite of it. I mean, the whole thing, alright?
The hell was that? Wait, do I hear that?
You all start to hear that.
Are we just shouting down a stairwell at each other or something?
Yes.
Yep.
Why don't you come up here and see for yourself?
All right, I'm heading forward. I have my gun pointed, and I, you know, tactical style walk.
Can I throw the remains of the speaker down the hole at them, or are they up the hole?
Of course you can. There's like a clanging, echoing sound. All right.
Here, take a look at this.
Clanging, echoey sound as it falls down the stairs and bangs off the wall.
The fuck? Why are you throwing stuff?
Look at it.
I look at it.
You can see, like, sparks of electricity forming around the wires on the wall, Omeda. As can you, Tris.
Seeing that, I know that's a bad thing, correct?
Yes.
Oh, God. I think you guys just made it worse for us.
I tore it off the wall.
Well, I know which one's the smartest one out of you two.
You're welcome.
All right, I'm still heading forward, and I headed more in. Still tactical style.
I'm still, like, not aiming a shotgun down the stairs. It's just one at my side. Just a person of average, just a woman of average height with, like, heavily taped over glasses and purple dreadlocks, wearing a long dark blue trench coat.
More
wastelander stuff.
And what does Omeda look like as she arises from the darkness?
Okay, Ned, I need to ask you, have you ever seen Dr. Seuss or orangutan or Dunstan?
I've seen an orangutan, but I have no clue what any of that stuff is.
Alright, picture a humanoid orangutan, all decayed looking, with a vest on. That's what you're seeing.
I had to show that.
Yeah, and he has an M1 Grant in his hand.
I mean, how common are mutants in this world?
Very.
Yeah, they're pretty. That's why
I love this place. This game. Well, that's the point.
I think being a very distinctly unmutated human might be stranger.
A very well clean human.
And immediately behind Trissa is obviously the super mutant with a
cloak. The hell is this big ass green wall behind you? By the way, I stopped like in mid range.
Glorklip?
Okay, hello Glorklip. I am Almeida.
Are you serious?
Down there.
Disjointed, digitized kind of female voice just from the area around you. There's no particular location it's coming from.
Mm-hmm.
if you would only listen to me, then I could save you. And you see the sparks kind of like converging into like a singular shape in the middle of the corridor.
What? We are. We found it. Like you said. We found it. We're gonna turn it on.
Raise your hand. By the way, I'm Tristessa. I do like haul. I do like long range. Long? Doesn't matter what I do. Hey, who is this person?
Me?
No, the person speaking in this. The weird thing, speaking in the speakers.
Oh, we don't know either. They said they can help us, so we're trying to help, and I think we found what we need to find and trying to do it right now.
Okay, there's a lot of vague things there. You're going to have to catch me up on what you're even doing. What? I'm just here to sell some scrap metal. What's this about?
We're trying not to die.
Okay, well, all of us do that every day, and some of us also like to bathe between that.
Yeah. What do you mean by that?
So, maybe take a step forward and pass the let's not die part?
Immediately beside you, Glorp, the electrical energy kind of converges and starts to take a humanoid sort of shape.
See, stuff like that. Now, I haven't seen anything that weird since... Well, never before in my life. Can someone explain what's going on?
How do I look at my equipment, like my character sheet?
Double-click on your icon. Or on the right-hand side, there's a people icon, and you can click it from the list. Just like your request.
Besides, you know what? Take me to the other people. I have no idea what's going on here with this thing. Especially with this thing. Standing there menacingly being strange. I don't want to be near it.
Oh yeah, don't come down here. There's a power. It's a power plant.
You can't let him inside it. It's too dangerous.
Is that what she said?
Yes.
Who just left?
Goose, though it sounds like they're having technical difficulties.
Yeah, I don't think this mic's working.
Wait, was Goose with us?
For the last half hour or something, yes. Okay, you're just running away now, correct?
Who, me?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking.
I'm just following after him. After Altoya. Almeida, there we go.
Yeah.
Altoya, Almeida. Glorp,
are you running after those two, or are you staying to play with the shiny thing?
That's a decision. Is everybody else running away from this thing?
Yes.
No, I'm trying to act. I'm trying to reason
trying to eat
with
it. I thought you were trying to reason with it.
Okay, you try to eat it. I'm trying to reason with it.
Clark's the voice of the wasteland. I'm just trying to bring peace to the fucking apocalypse with this thing.
Tressa, I don't envy you.
It takes the humanoid form, and then once it's finished, sort of fulfilling that form, it begins to become more like opaque and solidified. You begin to see like the feminine features of its face and where its hair would be.
I'm running away.
We never caught your name. What is your name?
Glorp Glip.
Not you, Glorp. Almeida. But anyway, I was talking about this thing.
Stacked up.
My name? I don't remember my name. I was one of them here, though. This was my place.
You said we found it. What did we find?
The center. The heart of the vault. Meanwhile, Mr. Pickles, you're down there in this room with this structure and all these cockroaches sort of hugging it. What would you like to do?
Would like to gently tiptoe closer to it, to a like control panel of some sort.
Yep, there is one there. It's all kind of cracked and covered in layers of dust. Probably need to brush off a couple of cockroaches.
Yeah. I definitely just grab one and just chuck it over my shoulder.
luck.
But I will trying to figure out what's the smart thing to do. I will attempt to like shut down the reactor, not like overload it or anything, but just like turn it off.
Okay, that's an understanding tech rule.
This is not going to go well.
See what you gone done did.
Yeah,
well,
I mean,
got a success.
There's not a lot you can figure out here. There's lots of meters and dials and switches and such. But you're pretty sure if you just grab this pair of levers with your little paws and just yank them downwards, it should turn it off.
Oh, fantastic. I will attempt to pull with my tiny little paws these two big levers.
You pull it and immediately the humming sound kind of just dies. And you start, there's a moment of just like silence. For all of you upstairs, any lighting that was on just immediately like switches off. And the electrical being that's kind of standing beside you sort of like flickers and judders erratically for a minute. And then you feel like a sense of panic. And then she screams in this high-pitched, digitized sort of sound.
Oh, Mr. Pickles, turn that back on!
Mr. Pickles, he was like just completely silent for a minute, just a pause of calm. And immediately, and then right afterwards, you just hear the clacks and just going, beep, 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 beep.
Turn it back on, Mr. Pickles!
Oh. Then you just hear the sound of like powers, just like lots of a series of things powering down.
Yeah, I think with the alarm and the ghostly wail, I will flip the switch back on.
All you hear in the silence is the shotgun sound.
You immediately push the levers back up again, but nothing happens. There's no like obvious like response to what's happening. You're like in complete darkness down there, Mr. Pickles.
See what you got.
I'm just, you know, where is your friends and or friends? There was three others.
Wait, how did they know that?
There were tracks in the snow. There were tracks outside.
Oh, well, Mr. Pickles is down there. Goose is supposed to be outside, but
I imagine Goose and Midge are like with you guys hanging around, just not doing anything.
Yeah,
He's back in the chat. I don't know what's going on with his mic though.
What the hell did you do, Mr. Pickles?
You guys, since you're kind of on the stairway where the electrical beam was, the lab that you just came from, Omeda, you hear like glass shattering.
Oh, damn.
Shit. Do you guys have weapons?
Well, at my side is a shotgun.
Perfect. You're going to need that. What about you, gloop, glop, gee, blop, bop, blop, bop, bop? I don't know what to say. That's how Omeda says names. Sorry. Glap!
What happened?
I said, do you have a sidearm or a weapon? Or?
Oh, yeah. I got a weapon.
Good, you're gonna...
I am the weapon. Come with me, skeleton man. I'm gonna pick you up. You're my weapon now.
You calling me a skeleton man?
You're my weapon now.
I'm not a skeleton. Man.
Ghoul. Skeletons.
I'm a damn orangutan. What the fuck?
Oh, fuck!
And by the way, are you close to me?
Yes.
Oh, man. Will that affect him? Dark?
Affect what?
Will your smell?
Yes.
What's it say in your description? I don't think it does.
It's just a dusk water-like smell.
Yeah, it's just... disgusting. I don't think it actually does anything.
Will that bother you?
Lord? No.
Well, I'm like, please don't touch me, thank you.
Okay, Glorp, you get to act first. You hear a glass smashing from below, and after the scream of the being beside you, what do you want to do?
Can I grab my orangutan friend and throw him into the heat of battle?
Can you not?
Can, but obviously she can resist.
Yeah.
When did I become a she? Damn.
I thought you were a female.
I'm not no female. What the fuck?
Whoa.
I thought you were.
No, I'm not.
Anyway, is that what you want to do, Glorp?
Nah, I will battle this monstrosity on my own. I'm going in.
Okay, so descending the stairs towards this end of the smashing glass.
Oh, yeah, that doesn't scare me at all.
I mean, it's. Do you have a light source? Do you have a flashlight or anything like that? Because you're in complete darkness.
Do Supermans not have night vision?
I don't believe so.
Ah,
it's
fuck.
It's not on your list. It wouldn't matter if you had night vision anyway, there's no light source.
I thought I had a rocket launcher. I don't remember.
That's attached to your motorcycle.
Does my shotgun have a light on it?
I mean, does it? I don't know.
I would assume it would, but I don't see it in the inventory, so I'm not sure if that's like a thing.
It wouldn't be, unless you'd had something that gave you it.
I guess I'm just gonna not go down there then. I'm just gonna go towards the entrance.
Back the way you came?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to try and find back the way you came. So,
sure.
Roll senses. Yeah, just senses. Yeah, you try and fumble your way back along the corridor you just came from and immediately trip over some cabling. There's a clatter and a loud thud as you hit the ground.
Where did you find him?
Triss, what would you like to do?
She just looks at what's her name again? Almeida. That's gonna take a while. That's gonna take a while to get used to. Let's look at Almeida and just say Eugene. And my shotgun does not have any lights or any sources. I was relying on the lights that just went out. But I'm just gonna bring my shotgun up and ready and say, can you see in the dark?
Mm-mm. Not really.
Yeah, Mets, do you have a light?
Yeah, but I'm kind of hesitant on using it.
Well, you know, you can either sit there and be hesitant about it, or you can help or you can help out and actually use it, because I don't know what's going on here, and no one's giving... You're not giving me some clear nouns and verbs and adjectives, so I'm just going by the seat of, you know, my pants. So... Either you start helping and, you know, so, like, we don't die. And also, where's your friends? They're downstairs?
Yes. Okay, then. Fine. Hold your breath and get behind me.
That's exactly what I'll do.
You want to hold your action. Wait. Basically.
Yeah.
Okay. Use here without seeing. The sound of something wet and heavy. Kind of like fumble and fall through a pair of swinging doors in the passageway below you. Yeah, oh, helps if I do this. Yes, you hear one of them kind of fall through the door, and then something immediately afterwards kind of let out a sound as it also kind of falls through the door into the passageway. Mr. Pickles. What would you like to do down in the dark on your own?
So I've flipped all the levers that I had previously flipped before.
Yes, you pushed them back up to the position they were in previously. But nothing seems to be happening.
Nothing seems to work, okay.
I think every second or so there's like a red flash in this room, so you get some light illumination momentarily.
That's actually scary.
Each time it flashes, though, you just see more and more... cockroaches filling the room.
Yeah. I will attempt to find other buttons and controls and hopefully fumble my way into turning the reactor back on without, you know, killing us all.
Well, I mean, the panel's right in front of you, so you can feel all the buttons and stuff there.
Yeah.
You want to try and work out how to turn it back on in the dark?
Yes.
Okay, so that's the understanding tech role, but it's going to be a higher difficulty.
That is fair. Oh, why is the chat window not opening up for me? What the hell? Oh, there we go. That was weird. And I, if two successes doesn't work, I will cash in my fortune.
Yes, cashing it in will be enough to figure something out there.
Okay, then I will do that. So I am now without fortune.
There is definitely some sort of sequence to turning these knobs and pressing these buttons in order to get it turned on. You've seen something similar before, but you do not know the exact sequence. You would need someone with the knowledge to instruct you how to.
Okay, well. Ooh, the office. I will attempt to scurry my way towards the office, which I will bring me to the rest of the group in our current predicament.
It has a senses roll. Yeah, just the attribute. Okay, yeah. Yeah, you're feeling your way around and having to pick up some cockroaches. You brush against something that you feel like is almost the same size as you before you manage to get your way out of the room. And then you just make like a beeline straight across in the darkness, frantically hoping that the other side is the stairway and the door that you came in from. Let's see if this one has any luck finding people. The third creature to come stumbling out of the lab clambers over the other two, and you can hear just like these wet feet sort of like ponderously making their way in your direction. Trissa and Omeda.
Mm-hmm.
You will, I take it Omeda is like closer to you, told Trissa to get behind you. You then feel like these wet fingers just like reaching out in the darkness and just beginning to like touch your face and shoulders, Omeda. For you, Glorp, after you fall, there is just like the kind of zzz, hissing sound of static, and then the being that was kind of standing beside you just pops and disappears. There's then another soft thud, Omeda, as another creature just falls out of the room in front of you in the darkness somewhere. And then it's your turn, Omeda.
Where Wait, so he's all to touching my, he's all touching my face?
Yes.
That's all he's doing?
In the first moments, yes.
Yeah, okay. So what I do is I move him with one hand and I bash him in the head with the cocktail.
With your Molotov?
Yeah. I just roll the
Okay, roll the cocktail. Roll the attack for it, yeah.
It point blank.
Point blank, trash. Swing in the dark, it moves aside, your Molotov hits the floor and just lights up the passageway in fire. You can see just a pile of these things at the doorway, sort of clambering over each other, as well as the one standing immediately beside you.
It wasn't lighted, though.
Oh, wasn't it? Okay, well, then you don't see anything. You just hear the glass smash and this slight smell of turpentine
because
in the air.
If I had a light, a lighter, I wouldn't, you know. But yeah.
Do you want to do anything, Trist, after you hear the smashing of glass?
I'm like, do you hear where that glass was? Shoot.
Yeah, I'm going to aim in that general direction of where that glass is and fire.
I don't think we need a roll for that. Yeah, the spark of the shell against the metal flooring ignites it. That lights up the passageway. You can see the creature standing immediately in front of Omeda, as well as the pile of them piled up in the doorway.
Okay. So I don't roll to attack?
No.
You didn't have to.
Because you just fired a shot.
Okay.
And then this creature lunges forward at Omeda and just like swipes at the air and misses her. Misses him. Okay, Glorp, what do you want to do?
I go to where they went.
So pick yourself up off the ground.
Yeah, I'm just trying to standing up.
You can see the light of the fire downstairs. I think that actually takes an action for you getting up off the ground though. So Trista, it'll be you again.
Rack a shell, aiming at the now visible creatures in fire.
Okay, roll the attack.
Okay. How do I do this?
Make sure your tokens clicked, and then click the attack macro. It should just do it.
Yeah, but I have a whole thing here now. What's the visibility? What's the difficulty? Target.
Oh, sorry.
Cover, aim bonus.
Yeah, so visibility is going to be total darkness.
Okay.
No, sorry, it's not total darkness because you lit it up. It'll be dark paint.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Difficulty?
Just regular difficulty because you're short distance.
And just hit them is not aiming specifically, just hitting in their area?
Yeah.
Are they stationary or are they moving?
There's one right in front of Omeda and then one beside that one standing. The rest of them are just a pile on the ground.
Okay, I'll just say stationary.
They would be stationary though, they're not moving at speed.
No.
You fired at the gap kind of between them. You thought maybe there was more than there are because they've got several heads, or some of them have several heads or several limbs. So you kind of like pick a target where you think a body mass should be, but there's not a body mass there. You just fire off into the darkness. This one stands up, and there's Mr. Pickles.
So the creatures are now visible, or they're still not?
If you're running out of the generator room up the stairs, you will see the flickering of the firelight. And you can hear the gunshot.
Okay, yeah, I pull out my nail gun and I run up the stairs.
You see
immediately
a mound of writhing bodies and limbs.
Ignoring the two new people, I will attempt to shoot the pile of limbs. Okay. Any difficulty modifiers or?
You can ignore dark break because you got the low light vision.
Yeah.
Everything else should just be as is.
Okay, cool.
See this one, 4 points of damage. That's you hit one in the arm with a nail, sure.
I contributed.
Okay, good boy, pat you on the belly and get you snacks.
Is there any way of moving through the door, or are they just all piled?
Right, it's not a big passageway, but I mean, you could try and scurry around, I'm sure.
I will attempt to, firing a nail into one of their many arms, Pickles will quickly try to scamper past them.
Nimbleness athletics. You're basically like, you're running all fours, right?
Yeah.
You don't run like holding stuff, so you'd have to holster your nail gun and then run. You just scarper over the top of them.
Yep.
Yeah, you can do that.
Awesome. I'm still trying to make my way towards the office where we found the recordings.
Okay, so this one is going to try and get Omeda again. How much armor do you have, Omeda?
9.
Yes, you do. You got light armor. So that's 2. So you're going to take 2 points of non-lethal damage.
Wait a minute, that's all I have. It's 2 points of non-lethal.
No, that you already have 2 points of non-lethal. You now have 4 points.
Oh.
So you have your health, the lethal damage you've taken, the non-lethal damage you've taken. When your lethal and non-lethal equals your health, then you're down.
Okay. Makes sense.
But you'll need to change the 2 to 4.
I did.
Right, okay. And then this next one, same thing again. Dark break. And that's 2 more you'll take.
6.
Okay, that's going to do a thing. That's the wrong thing. Okay. This one just stood up, so then this one is also going to lunge for you, Almeida. I'm afraid. But it swipes at the air and misses you, so now it's your turn.
So what, all these things around me?
Well, they're all in front of you. As well as the raccoon that just kind of hopped over the top of them.
In front of me is like a conga line?
More like just like a crowd.
Oh. Oh, I shove the crowd. Too many crowd in there! Just shove them all away.
Okay, you want to roll muscle athletics?
Fuck, what I do there? Roll successes?
Roll success, yeah.
Okay, I see what you did. Yeah,
that's enough to push them back. I mean, you're a big, strong orangutan. You give them a massive shove, and they all kind of, like, stammer, just, like, fall backwards. They don't have a lot of balance or coordination, and they all just kind of fall backwards on top of each other again in a big pile. Unfortunately, Mr. Pickles is caught under some of them.
Shouldn't have got in front of me, damn.
Does he make raccoon sounds of distress, though?
Of course I do.
Yeah.
Okay, that's important for me to know.
One of them managed to sort of struggle to its feet. Glorp. What would you like to do?
Avoid it.
I mean, your two buddies are on the bottom of the stairs. There's a fire in front of them, and then just a big pile of wet bodies.
You said wet bodies?
Yeah, like wet people. Or things that vaguely look like people.
I'm gonna eat a body.
Well, I mean, how would you do that?
I'm just gonna pick it up by the wrist and just take a big chunk out of his arm.
So push past your friends in front of you.
Oh, I thought they're down the thing.
They're at the bottom of the stairs and you're on the stairs.
I guess I'm just gonna wait.
Alright, Tress, what would you like to do?
So all of the people-looking things have been pushed down onto their backs in front of us?
Except for one, which managed to get to his feet.
Okay, the one that's on its feet is gonna get shot, and she's gonna shout at, Almeida, beat the damn things on the ground's brains out. If you need something, grab the bat sticking out of my backpack.
Okay.
Yeah, 60 points is definitely going to kill it. Yes, you will blow the top half of that thing's torso to smithereens.
You just hear the shell just racking the next, and the empty casing just ejects.
I am.
One of them, which is bulkier and broader than the rest, sort of just like Incredible Hulk, shove the rest of them like aside and roars as it pushes itself through them all to stand up in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Make that two of them. Okay, Pickles.
Am I still pinned underneath one of them?
Yeah, I would think so.
All right, cool. Well, since I was running, that means I don't have a weapon in my hand. I will attempt to turn around in my fur and bite at whatever is pinning me down.
Sure. To equip your bait and roll the attack.
Yeah,
you did 3 points of damage. It's good for you.
And that I will attempt to escape.
Nimble athletics. Oh yeah, you can definitely bite that and scurry between all their limbs to make a retreat there. These boys are going to try and stand up. Fails. Oh, that one does stand up though. Three here standing. This one is going to do a thing. And then this one's just going to try to stand up. Which it fails to do. Okay, Almeida. Two of them are still lying on the ground. Three of them managed to get to their feet.
And I'm going to move way back. Better move back!
Oh, okay. Behind Tress, oh, behind Glorp.
I go, Tress and Glorp, move back, move back. I'm tired of getting hit.
Yeah, I mean, you could do that. Glip, Glorp, Glip.
You can be forward if you want.
I will shoot my gun in the enemy's direction.
Okay. Roll the attack for your guy. You don't have your gun equipped, though. You have your bludgeon equipped. You'd have to unequip that and then equip the shotgun.
I'm just going to go attack him with my bludgeon.
Right, okay. So roll attack for that, then. Let's see, is this boy... Yep, you charge through the two people in front of you and just start smashing one of them with your big club. Knocking it to the ground before you choose to beat it to death or not. Okay, Tress.
Okay, Rakishel, take aim at one of these, one of the things that surged to its feet and fire again.
Okay. Well, that is definitely a miss. I guess the one that you just shot at will lunge forward to try and attack you. And it misses. And then the other one is standing up. How much armor do you have, Triss?
Whatever a coat counts as.
So none. So you would mark 4 points of non-lethal. So when it says NL underneath your health, just put in 4.
Okay.
And then it's Mr. Pickles again.
Am I being directly threatened by any of them?
Not at the moment, no.
Then I will continue to scamper towards the office.
So I believe that's upstairs into the other lab that's empty.
Yeah.
Well, you have enough light here, I think you can kind of see where you're going, so that's not a problem. You can just move up there and into that room.
Awesome. I will attempt to look for a... hopefully a how to turn on the nuclear reactor sequence.
Senses notice with a very high difficulty.
Yeah, I kind of regret changing my using my fortune, but it is what it is. Hey, 3 successes.
That is exactly what I was thinking you would need.
Yeah, thank God.
Yeah, there's a very big, very thick, dusty manual in one of the drawers, which is all about like the power plant and how it's set up. If you could find a decent light source, you might be able to start to save from it.
Great, cool. So since I can't run on with carrying something, I will hold this thick-ass book and attempt to waddle my way down the stairs back to where the fighting is or where the light source is.
Okay, roll away muscle athletics, because you'll need to drag it with your... while your teeth are sunk into it.
Well, I was thinking I was walking on my hind legs, but it's muscle what? Athletics?
Muscle athletics. It'd be the same really anyway.
Yeah, you say that.
Yeah, it's difficult as you start and you're like, Yeah, you're going to struggle with that for a little bit.
Yep, that's fair.
Can this guy stand up? Nope. This one is standing up. So I guess Glorp, who is... Oh, this one's been beaten by Glorp, actually. So I guess it's going to try and get out from under Glorp. Yeah, Glorp, so you smash this thing a couple of times, it hits the ground... I don't know if you don't pay attention to it or whatnot, but then after it hits the ground, ribs broken as it is, it like rolls out of the way and like leans against the wall and like pulls itself up on its feet again. Mr. Pickles, you start hearing like static electrical kind of sound all around you, and you see the sparks along the wall move and start to take shape in the room that you're standing in.
Oh, cool. Great.
And this one doesn't. Okay, Amita, it's you again.
All right. Take out my grant. And click. God damn it.
Bang, miss. Glorp, gunshot goes off beside you.
All right. Misfire.
I'm going to hit the guy with a stick again.
The one you hit before?
Or maybe a different one. I don't know. We'll find out.
Which one is it before you roll it?
Same one would be fine.
Same one. Okay, nearest one. Yes, that one. You smack it once hard in the head, smooshing the head against the wall and just turning it to paste.
Non-lethally, no doubt.
Well, it does say non-lethal, doesn't it? I don't see how that could be non-lethal.
You know. Putty.
I mean, it does say that, like, if the non-lethal damage, you can go into overflow and it becomes lethal.
Yeah, and that is overkill, so I'm guessing that's a death. Yeah. Okay, gotcha. Tris. Glorp does what Glorp does and smooshes one.
Going to try and get some distance between me and these things, if that's at all possible.
Exactly.
You want to roll in nimbleness athletics? Yeah, you try to back off, but the one that's kind of like, the one you weren't shooting at kind of comes up the side of you and like wraps its arms around you.
Just shout, no, get off me, you creep, you weird thing. God, I need to take a shower.
I resent that.
I'm not talking about you.
And then you take another 4 points of non-lethal.
Okay.
However, the one you were shooting at just sort of swipes where you were standing a second ago and misses you. Mr. Pickles, you're standing there and the ghost thing is like forming in the room in front of you. As you're struggling with this big heavy book.
I will redouble my efforts. Actually, as the electricity is forming in the room, is that sufficient enough light?
The flickering lights of electricity? With your night vision?
I'll take what I can get. I'll take what I can get.
I mean, I'm gonna make you roll. Senses, and then just set the sense to 6. Or set the skill to 6, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, it's enough light to read it by, yes. But you're still need making understanding tech to figure out what it is you want to be looking for.
That's fair. I was gonna try to like skim through, and I will rip pages out as necessary to make this interload.
Yeah, it's obviously a very high tech device, so.
For sure. For sure, but yeah, I will staring at the electric ghost that's for me, I will quickly, like, throw open the book and just start, like, frantically trying to understand and figure out what I need out of this book.
Yeah, understanding tech.
Ooh.
I'm afraid it's too complicated for you.
Yeah, I guess that's all I could do.
Or not do. Okay, so the ghost form solidifies, or begins to solidify in front of you, and it like leans forward as you're flicking through these pages really quickly, and you see the feminine form of its face kind of lean in towards you. And it's almost like it has a voice of like desperation about it. And it's saying, Hemmings, why? Why did you turn it off? I was in the room.
I will shrug at the ghost.
You have to turn it back on before it's too late. The whole vault will explode.
I even more frantically point at the book.
Why are you reading the manual? Come, I will show you. And it begins to like fade as it like turns to walk out the room, and every step it takes it just like fades away more and more.
Okay.
And then this guy is going to track attack Triss again. And misses. Almeida, your turn.
Is Triss right but next to me or
Triss go in front of you because you ran behind her, remember?
I know, I told everyone move back. But whatever.
I tried to. I couldn't break away.
Alright, I'll shoot the one front of Triss. Here we go. Finally, a success. It's the best.
That blast will knock that one back prone on the ground. And then it's Glorp. There is only one creature standing. It has its arms wrapped around Triss.
How do I switch to my shotgun? This seems like the right tool for the job.
You click on your weapon that's equipped, put that back into your backpack, and then click on your shotgun and put that into your hands. Is your shotgun in a holster or a backpack or what?
I don't know.
I mean, if you can't tell me, I'm going to tell you.
A backpack, I guess.
Okay, well then you'll spend your turn swapping weapons. So Triss, what do you want to do?
I would like to not be held, and I would like to break away. If I can.
Yes. Where's the grapple thing here?
I don't know. I
think it's muscle brawl you need to roll. Or you can go nimbleness brawl. If you're trying to slip out. It has a very firm grip of you because it has three arms. Luckily these guys, no, he gets back on his feet, never mind. I was going to say luckily they're not very good at standing up. Yeah, so the one that has you is then going to try and take a chunk out of you. And takes another 4 points of non-lethal on you. Mr. Pickles,
I am unconscious if that's the case.
Yep.
Oof. I will attempt to. I will abandon the book then, and try to scamper back towards the reactor.
Yeah, I mean, there's fire still going out there, and there's enough noise that you can easily find your way back down to those guys. There's Triss has now been knocked unconscious by this creature with three arms. The rest of them, one more of them is standing up, although it's like a big chunk's been taken outside of it. And the other two are still just flapping about on the ground.
I will go ahead and kind of stop as I get towards them, and I'll pull out the Tesla rifle again.
Mm-hmm.
And I will attempt to zap one of the creatures.
The one holding Triss, or the other one standing up?
So Goose can hear us, he just can't talk.
Speak, yeah.
The question is, where is Goose?
I'm imagining having Midger just like fighting off other ones in the room. Because there was a whole chamber full of them.
Yeah.
So maybe occasionally you hear like gunshots going off and Goose like yelling like, "Die, you motherfucker!" He's like stabbing him with his spear.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to shoot your gun then?
Would shooting the one that's holding Tess with the rifle, would that harm her or?
No. If you hit it, you hit it. I mean, maybe we could go increase the difficulty by targeting a specific area.
Nah, yeah, I'll just hit him.
Yeah, 48 is going to fry it, yes.
All right, cool. And then I will quickly hop over its corpse and make my way back towards the reactor in the hopes that the ghost will show me how to turn it back on.
Fails to stand up. That's going to do its thing. Fails to stand up. Almeida. There's just a stream of lightning goes past you and then frazzles one of the creatures. There is only one left standing. Triss is lying on the floor unconscious.
While it's still hugging her? Or?
No, that one got frazzled. Fried. Burnt.
Where's the other one?
Sort of stammering around in the corridor as the raccoon scurries past it.
I just scamper past and I just hiss out, "Fix! Fix!"
That is enough to kill the last one. That's standing.
Is it close to me?
It's in close distance, yeah. I mean, you're all in this corridor at the bottom of the stairs. The only ones left are the two on the ground. As it's Glorp's turn.
Oh, that was an action? Oh, okay.
You can move around or something after you fire if you want.
Oh, I was going to try to grab Tess.
Yeah, I mean, with those big ape arms, definitely. Glorp. You now have pulled out your shotgun. There are two of them left on the ground.
I'm going to shoot them. Please unequip extra weapons.
Yeah, make sure you unequip the other weapon.
I'm still unconscious, I assume?
Hang on. Yeah, he's just shooting. Yes, that one's dead. The very loud sound of a shotgun going off in a tight, confined space once more. Ending the life of that one. Yeah, yes, you will be unconscious still until someone revives you, I think. Mr. Pickles.
I run past and into the reactor room and hope that the ghost shows herself.
Yeah, I mean, you run down here again into the darkness, open up the door, and you can hear the scuttling sound of the cockroaches in the large space before you.
Okay, in that case, I will... knowing that I probably should avoid hitting the reactor, I will kind of aim the Tesla rifle almost at the ground immediately in front of my feet. And fire kind of just spray the Tesla rifle around me, and hopefully I fry a bunch of bugs.
So point blank into the room.
Yes.
See, it doesn't seem so smart when I say it, does it?
No, it doesn't.
I'm trying to think how to do this because you're not really aiming for anything in particular.
No.
Okay, you can fire it, but. Use the spray option.
Yeah. Spray multiple targets.
Yes, I mean, that is enough to send a large swath of the roaches scattering as it, like, sparks and connects with different points of the room and the structure around it. You're going to see larger roaches in amongst the smaller ones, however, which are sort of just, like, lurking, waiting, like, predators.
Large as in... my size or bigger?
Yes would be the answer.
I don't like that answer. Then I hold my action to do whatever the ghost says when she shows up. Cause hopefully she shows up.
This one's on the ground and still gonna drag up. And it does get to its feet and amongst the rest of you. You can hear, I don't think you can hear, but you will sense with your senses this sort of static field just sort of moving through the area you're in, Pickles. All your hair sort of like stands up on end, your whiskers are all like twitching and sensitive. And you can probably see like a path of cockroaches moving around and clearing away as this like field like moves past you across the room. And you can just hear a soft kind of whispering on the wind sort of voice just like, please hurry, there isn't much time.
Yeah, I kind of try to follow the field as best as I can.
Umeda.
I don't like being close to it, but I'll stay as close as I can to it.
Okay, Umeda, there is one creature standing on its feet now in the passage before you.
Right next to me?
A few feet in front of you.
Alright.
I think you ran out of ammunition in your last shot. It said you did.
Yeah, I did. Oh, I gun butt it.
Oh, you gun butt? Okay. Yeah, I will need to make that see which weapon it is. 8 points of non-lethal is not enough to knock it prone on the ground again, but you do smack it.
No, that's lethal. I changed it to lethal.
Oh, lethal, sorry. Well, I mean, it's still not enough to put it down.
But it said ouch!
It did say ouch. Okay, so fortunately for Mr. Pickles, all these roaches go first. You'll be fine, they have to find you first.
Yeah, okay, sure, fair enough.
Oh, well that one definitely found you, so it's on your tail.
Okay.
And this one also found you. I don't know how many rounds being unconscious is to knock you out for, if someone has to actually do something to wake you up.
Okay, I'll just vibe until someone wakes me up.
I can't see it searching in the PDF even.
Rip.
Yeah, because it's got it for dying, but I don't see knockdown. All your damage is non-lethal, right?
Yeah.
You want to roll a toughness only roll?
Autonomy.
Oh wait, I know what it's going to be. It's just going to be healing time, so it's in like minutes. Yeah, I think it's going to be like however many rounds a minute is. Natural healing. Toughness inboxes per hour.
Okay, so I can't do anything for the whole encounter.
And not unless someone like cheats you with something to accelerate that.
Okay.
I think Glorp is probably the closest one to this creature. Do you have any armor, Glorp? No. Yes, you do.
Yes.
You have two. Okay, so you're going to take 2 points of non-lethal damage. And then it is you, Pickles. As you are following this field, you can probably sense the predators closing in on you.
I will, if I can't see them, right?
You can do a senses roll. Because you've got the smell and the hearing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could do a senses notice.
With the skill set to 6?
Yeah. I think that's what it says for enhanced senses.
Yeah,
you know where they are, where they're coming from.
Cool. I will take aim at the closest with my Tesla rifle, and I will shoot it.
And roll to shoot. Do you want to spray so you can hit multiples?
I will actually spray.
Yeah so it rolls and then you just divide the successes between however many of them you want to split it between.
Okay, so 2 of them, I guess.
That will fry 2 of them dead.
Sweet. I kind of just sort of hiss at where I know at the field. It's just like, you know, try to hurry up as much as possible.
Glorp, what would you like to do? There is one creature still standing.
I'll attack him.
Just roll attack with your weapon then. Yes, kaboom, very much dead. Shotgun blast. The whole torso just like blows into smithereens, and the passageway is clear. It's just littered with the organic debris. Seeing that you are shooting electric beams everywhere, the form starts to become like opaque again, although it's like still sort of semi-translucent in front of you, as it turns around and just in wonderment and just like looks at you for a second, Pickles, and then it like stretches out its one hand towards the area where the cockroaches are. Okay. And fries one of them. There's this stream of electricity just comes sparking out of its fingers and just zaps one of them like a bug killer.
Yay, I made friends with the ghost.
Okay, Ilmeda, all of the creatures are dead.
Alright. Gonna go see if I can help Mr. Pickles.
Sure, you run downstairs power plant, you open the door, you see him halfway across the chamber with the ghost thing standing in front of him. And you come in just as like this zap electricity comes out from the ghost's fingers towards the ground in front of where Mr. Pickles is.
There anything? Wait, these two are around, or?
Yes, they're like lurking in the darkness around him. I would need you to roll notice them though.
All right, success appeal.
Senses notice.
Senses.
You have enhanced senses as well, don't you? Mutation. Do you? No, you don't actually.
Two successes. This is...
Yeah, you're not going to see them.
Wait, I'm not?
No, because they're small and it's dark and they are lurking in the shadows.
Oh.
You'll know there's cockroaches on the floor and stuff because you can see them and hear them moving around.
Loomis, that's what I'm going to call you.
Just yell out across the room.
Yeah, to her. Can't see.
Okay then. How much armor you got, oh, Mr. Pickles?
Wait, did she done say anything back? I mean, okay.
Yeah, she'll look up at you and be like, another one.
I have light armor, so that's 2 armor.
Okay, so you take 4 lethal damage from the bait. And because it's a successful bait, I also need you to roll toughness.
Just straight toughness?
Yeah. Oh, you're fine. Except it's going to happen again.
Yeah, I still take the 4 lethal damage, right?
Yeah, plus another 4.
Oh, okay.
And then roll toughness again. Okay, you are now suffering from radiation sickness.
Cool.
Unfortunately, she can't do anything, so it's now your turn, Pickles. That would do anything for a while, though.
Yeah, that's fair. I will attempt to zap the 2 cockroaches.
Okay, so maybe click spray. You need what's your ammunition as well when you're doing this. Because the spray uses 5 every time.
Oh, it does.
Yes, they're both very dead. One powerful blast and they are bug zapped instantly.
Welcome back.
Yeah, Omeda, you know he's got this gun, but it kind of looks like he's just like copying the ghost as he like points the gun and zaps the darkness, because you can't see what he's zapping with his lightning gun. Imagine some sparks of the gun hit the ghost at the same time as well, and it like blows brighter for a second and becomes more opaque.
Wait, I can see now, right?
You can see them, yeah, because as the ghost glows more, you can see better.
Alright, I'd start going forward to them. Luminous, put your head up and then make the, we can't see anything.
Be careful, Hemmings. A ghoul, and she starts to raise her hand.
I try to frantically wave at the ghost and just point at the reactor.
Oh wait, I need to see if I can understand you.
Yep.
Oh dear.
Fuck's sakes.
Yeah, it raises his hand and like sparks start coming out of the end of its fingertips, but they just sort of move around and connect to all the metal structures around. They don't go far enough to reach Omeda.
What are you doing?
Come, Hemmings, we haven't much time.
Yeah, Pickles has tried to frantically communicate to everyone, but yeah.
Glorp, you're left upstairs with an unconscious Driss. I'm not sure what
your two's... I'll wake them up.
Yeah, okay. Can you make an understanding heal roll? Okay. I guess you can get one damage undone, Triss.
Okay.
You kind of come to and there's just the familiar yet ugly face of Glorp kind of staring down at you.
I use the blood of the monster to wake him up.
Yeah, like one big finger dabbed in blood, just like painting it on your cheek.
Give him the Simba.
Just cough and try and slowly pull myself up on my feet.
Yeah, looking around, you're just surrounded by guts and half bodies that have been blown apart.
Welcome back to the spirit realm.
Is the power back on?
No.
Okay. No. Just look around.
There's a lot of frantic raccoon noises being made, and yeah.
I mean, the passage you're in has the fire still burning on the floor.
Yeah, I'm just gonna lean against the wall, throw my head back, and just sigh and go, ugh, which way did those people go?
I'm gonna point in the opposite direction that they went.
So you point back out the stairs the way you came.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna turn my head and shut up there. Hey, you up there?
I'm just gonna shrug and walk the other way.
So you look the other way, so you do go the right way.
I go the right way, but I point him in the wrong way. Yeah, and I walk down the hallway eating my newly acquired snack, which is actually an arm off one of these monsters.
I'm just gonna stand there, I guess. And go in the wrong direction because I have no reason to suspect otherwise.
I mean, he walked in the right direction after pointing you in the other direction. So I don't know how well Triss knows Glorp since you've spent time together.
That's a good question.
Glorp's master survival of the wasteland.
But yes, Pickles, you, Omeda, and the ghost.
Hurry up, Mr. Pickles. I'm gonna go back upstairs. I'm not welcome here.
Yep, still just try to frantically get the ghost's attention, pointing at the reactor.
I mean, almost as if she's acting out a different scene. She like makes like talking motions, moving her arms around before turning and going through the doors into the generator room.
I follow her.
You see her turning as if she's banging her hands against the door that she just came in, and she's like making the motions as if she's screaming, but she's not making any sound.
Right, yeah, she's reliving the memory. I was just gonna say, are there any levers or things in here to push?
It's the same room you were in before. You're going back down to the generator room, yeah.
Yeah, no, I'll just kind of try to keep following her.
Yeah, I mean, waiting a few moments, she kind of like finishes acting out whatever she's doing before she like she walks over and just like stands in front of the panel, and then just looks over at you. Why are you just standing there? I don't have much time.
Yeah, this is. I can wander over to where she's at by the panel.
She starts just like pointing out levers, switches.
I do my best to flip and push each and every one.
So make an understanding. I guess just an understanding.
Oh, just understanding.
Well, understanding tech. I mean, it's going to be the same thing. But you're going to have 3 bonus dice.
Ooh, okay.
Yes, with her guidance, you're able to like hit in the correct sequence of switches and buttons and such. And as you the power boots up and starts to come on again, the lights come on, and you can see all these dials lighting up and meters lighting up, and you can see like how close to meltdown the reactor became. At which point the ghost turns around to you and asks you, Hemmings, why did you leave me here? You knew I needed your help. You didn't even come looking for me.
Let's see. I hold up my bottle of antibiotics and I try to obviously I can't communicate well, but I try to communicate that I was looking for help. I was trying to look for help.
So you're going to roll appeal and persuade, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah, that's enough for her not to immediately zap you.
I mean, I'm just playing a part, trying to give this coast some peace.
The face changes from that sort of desperate, whimpering sort of expression to a more stern and immediate serious one. And the whole figure becomes, as the lights go on, the whole figure becomes more opaque and just solidified to the point where you feel like you could reach out and just like touch her and she would like have like skin. Although it's like flickering and light lit up at the same time. And she leans down towards you and just looks at you inquisitively and says, what are you? You shouldn't be here.
I chitter in agreement.
Did you survive the bombs? Has the war ended?
I nod my head, yes.
You have others here. I can feel them.
Nod my head, yes, again.
And she looks at the generator and then looks at you. Have you come to destroy it?
I shake my head no.
She glides through you and walks out of the door into the chamber where Omeda is. And as she sees you, Omeda, she kind of stops for a second and then continues walking towards you. You, ghoul, do you speak?
Yes.
I cannot communicate with your creature friend.
Yeah, he doesn't really talk that much. I mean, he does, but it's incoherent.
How did you get in here?
The door was open.
She like stops for a second as if she's listening to something. But it is no longer open.
Yeah, it closed at the time. It was open at first, but then it closed itself.
I will make you a bargain, creature. If you and your friends will promise to bring me something I can inhabit, something I can walk out of here with.
What would that be?
I will allow you to leave.
What were those things that we fought?
The Liberty Boat. Oh, you told me the things here?
Yes.
She was confused for a second. She doesn't know what you're talking about. Oh, right. I was attempting something that didn't work out.
Okay, now what do you need? You need a livery bot, you said?
Yes, one of those would be spectacular. But any robot machine would work.
I hold up my Tesla rifle.
Can you get into that?
Shakes her head. She's like, No. It must be something I can move with my own power.
Mr. Pickles, do we still have that robot?
I think we took it apart, honestly.
Yeah, he took it apart.
Alright, deal. We're trying to find something to get you out of here with. Is there anything around here that you haven't been able to reach, or...?
I haven't been able to leave this vault in a very long time. My current form doesn't allow me to.
So there's no any type of robots around that you can't get? Got it.
Not in here, but there used to be... There was a factory in the city, north of here. If this city still stands.
Okay.
You may find one there.
Okay. Can you reopen the door?
She pauses for a second to consider. Yes, I will do that for you. You can hear the klaxons and the shifting of the gears and the moving of the door in the distance up the corridor. Glorpa and Trissa, who haven't been aware of this conversation at all, will hear the door opening in the distance.
Alright then, we're heading out to get you a body. And I start to head out. Wait, is there anything else?
No, she just kind of stands there and starts looking like lost again for a second. As if she's not quite sure where she is. You probably turn around and Glorp's coming down the stairs eating a human arm.
I stop him. Other way.
What's that mean?
Go the other way. We're done here. We need to find a robot.
Oh, I've seen one before. Robots.
I'm actually going to pull the fuel cell out of my Tesla rifle.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it only had like three, you know, shots left in it.
Uh-huh.
But I will just place it at the where, you know, kind of in front of the ghost and just kind of
walk away. Shit, I can't. Or can I?
Do what?
Oh, I was going to rush back. I was like, wait. Wait here. I tell that the gloop glop, glip glop, whatever. Glop. And I run back. What is your name?
Don't you know me, Hemmings? I'm Fran.
Okay, Fran, I need to find ammunition. Do you have ammunition in this vault?
Weapons? Yes, we will need weapons when the communists arrive.
Yes. Communists. I need ammunition. I'm out of ammo.
Let me see if she remembers.
Hmm?
Let me see if she remembers.
Oh, okay. Nope.
No, she doesn't remember where. She just starts babbling about preparing for the war.
Okay, never mind.
But you just go back up the stairs with Glorp. You find Triss like leaning against the wall, catching her breath, barely staying on her feet.
Welcome back to the living. We have a mission.
I can feel, so I'm still alive.
Wonderful. We need to find a robot. Do you know where we can find a robot?
I can think of someone, but I don't think that's your definition of a robot.
Okay, then no. Alright, we're going to this factory then.
Not unless she wants someone who seems like a robot. I'm sure we can.
I never told you who needed a robot. Unless you were there.
Shit, you're right. No, my bad. That's me being a fuck about out of character. I assume. Let me take a step back. Not unless whoever is sending you for that doesn't mind us getting a guy who acts like a robot. I'm sure Eugene has some people like that.
No.
Damn. Then I'm out of ideas.
So I don't know if I mean, obviously, you wouldn't know because you weren't here when we did it, but Eugene is actually run by raccoons now.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I did not know that.
They keep humans as kind of like pets, but it's run by raccoons.
Yep. It's the home of the Raccoon Federation.
Okay, then we can go to Portland and find someone. I'm sure it'll be fine. I'm sure we can kidnap someone who's just kind of nerdy and it'll count.
I shake my head and try to communicate, you know, need a robot.
Wrap someone up in tinfoil.
I'm sure if we wrap them up in metal, it'll count, right? Right?
Mm.
But,
yeah. Alright.
Yes, the vault door is open. You can freely leave now.
I do so.
Leaving, the first thing you'll see will be Glorp's motorcycle. And you're probably wondering, how the fuck did that get up here?
Glorp's strong, humans weak.
I just want to dedicate this one to all the cowboys out there. R.I.P., you miserable fucks. I love all my lady muties out there. I just want some titties for once that ain't growing their second cousin out of the nipple, you dig? Get yourself some lotion.
Fuck?
God damn. Old Mount Hoodie is looking pretty fiery today. I ain't the pessimistic.
That's not new.
I'd say we're all gonna die.
When you say cowboys, I have too much brain rot. I thought he was gonna say Ram Ranch.
Well. Almost, but not quite. We definitely killed a bunch of cowboys, though.
With the nine men, some in a council nine. Boom.
Yes, as you come to the entrance, you hear the radio from the motorcycle and you look out across the landscape of Oregon, which is probably a kind of overcasty.
Oh, that's good. I look at Tess and I give her a thumbs up.
Why is he giving me a thumbs up? Why is
you know why.
And I'm just gonna collapse out of the bunker, out of the vault. I mean,
I also hand over my bottle of antibiotics.
That's Mr. Pickle.
It's a raccoon's understanding of medicine.
Yeah.
I don't think the skin was punctured.
I just open up the bottle and I chomp on a pill. Like, you know, yeah, see, it's good.
Severely out of date antibiotics. What harm can they do?
Does he get sick?
Well, he's already sick. He has radiation sickness.
Oof.
I need some milk.
It'll be a while before his hair starts falling out.
Can I offer him a bite of my human arm to cure his radiation sickness?
You can.
Would you like some arm?
Hey, is that raccoon okay? Why is he eating pills?
I give a thumbs up again.
Oh, wait, you got radiation. Okay, Prom, I need you to roll toughness, but set the toughness to 6. So just for the attribute, just go set to 6.
Yeah, I'll just like closing the thing.
I thought you were immune to radiation, but you're just resistant.
Am I not immune to it?
Not completely, no.
Cracking and whacking and flacking. Tracking.
Wait, what am I attribute? What? Toughness?
There's an option there for set to 6, just use that one. Okay, you're fine. Yeah, tuning that arm will do you no harm at all.
So I can't eat arms anymore?
You can eat arms just fine. But that arm in particular, you had to test for radiation. You will make your way back down the mountain, you will find Gertrude and your other vehicles that you left hidden by the lake. And then further down, Triss will have her semi-hauler truck.
Yep. My big purple truck that could probably, that's like a house on wheels.
You might be slightly impressed by their vehicle because they have an SUV that has a heavy grenade launcher and a heavy machine gun on it as well. And has nearly as much
armored.
Life as... Yeah, has nearly as much health as your hauler has.
Damn.
Looks like a fucking military APC at this stage.
Although the back of it is just full of like garden chairs and chicken mesh wire and bicycles.
Bikes.
Damn, I probably shouldn't have been a hauler. Okay.
No, it works. We kind of pooled our vehicle points together, so.
Omida has his own motorcycle. Yeah. The mud pod.
But yes, yeah. Well, this truck is also kind of my home.
Yeah.
It even has a. It allegedly has a working shower 3 days out of 7.
What are you trying to say?
That I have some decent comforts.
I feel attacked again.
I
also have Bath and Body. I'm like, okay, you know what?
I am a reasonable person. No, not.
Well, I will climb into the driver's seat of Gertie, and I will reattach the steering wheel.
I'm getting in the mod pod. Hacking and jacking.
Yes, when we come back next time, we'll start with a roll to see if there's anything on your journey back to Portland.
Nice.
And I'll get the map set up so we can actually see all the locations where you can go.
Yeah.
And then we can actually do some light exploring.
Yeah,
that was awesome.
And hopefully Goosey's microphone works.
Yeah. And at least he hopefully got to listen in on our shenanigans. Well, that's good.
Cool.
Yeah.
As long as we got a couple of people showing up, I don't expect all 6 people to be here every week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's fair.
I'll be here next week, but not the week after.
Yeah.
This is KRABY, funded exclusively through your generous donations.
But I think
and the distribution
after that, I should
narcotics.
Be good for the rest of the summer.
Awesome.
No, that was fun, even though I got knocked out pretty early on.
Yeah. You don't have a lot of life, man, so it doesn't take much to get you.
Yeah. The Atomic Highway is kind of a deadly system.
You did a good job and good work.
Shai's character has 4 med kit uses. So when she's around, you can get healed at least.
Yeah. When she's around.
I have to invest in some anti-radiation gear, aren't I?
It's Fallout. It's fine.
Oh yeah, let's make it.
That sounds like a bad thing.
You just drink some milk. It's fine.
I'm gonna elect to not believe you on that one and make my first investment something like anti-radiation gear.
You just lose some hair and then you're immortal.
That sounds awful. Some people don't want to live forever. That just sounds like torture.
It's fine. Fucking rad roach. Yeah, no, this was fun. I really like using Foundry. That's awesome.
I'm just writing the effects of your radiation sickness here.
Uh-oh.
When did he get irradiated?
Fucking rad roach bit me, and I didn't roll good on my...
Okay, that's how it works. Okay. I wasn't sure if there was an event in an earlier session that you were still dealing with the effects of it.
Nah.
I wish y'all to, yeah, I'll see you guys later.
Later.
At least I finally got to pick my perk.
Okay, so...
Yeah, like...
Every day in-game, you'll make a roll for your radiation sickness. Every time you don't pass it, your radiation level goes up one. And each time it goes up one, it acts as a difficulty increase to all your physical rolls.
Oh. Okay.
If you take, like, rad pills, you don't have to make the roll. You just auto-pass it that day.
Oh, okay. But, yeah. That obviously requires a reliance on rad pills. Is there a cure, or... I mean, obviously, Pickles probably doesn't know, but...
If you can find something interesting to use as a cure, yeah, sure.
Interesting. Okay.
I was thinking about the brewery place you wanted to go to. They might have something.
Oh, yeah, that'd be great, yeah.
If we use stalker logic, drinking alcohol cures radiation poisoning.
Yeah. Well, Goose actually wants to go to, like, a mutant brewery, too, so that actually works.
So,
but,
if we give the raccoon alcohol poisoning from vodka, he'll be cured.
Cheeky breeky of donkey.
Exactly.
I mean, I'm already a raccoon. I'm already, like, permanently squatting.
We get Cossacks and take a trip out to the Rosta.
Yeah.
Okay, so add radiation sickness to your long list of mutations and flaws.
How many mutations does he have?
Well, because I'm a raccoon, I start with mutations, which are basically just, you know, features of being a raccoon.
Mm-hmm.
But I also have, you know, because I'm intelligent, I'm obviously not a normal raccoon. I'm bigger and weirder. So just as like a raccoon, I've got enhanced hearing and smell. I'm a good climber. I've got night vision. I can bite. I'm colorblind. I've got a speech impediment because a raccoon's snout isn't good for talking human words. I can say some things, but like you need to roll an understanding in order to figure out what I'm saying. And then now I've got, oh yeah, I'm also a partial biped, which means that if I want to run, I have to have my hands free because I run on all fours.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, I'm like moving really, really slowly. And then I have a distinctive odor because I'm a fucking raccoon.
So where in any of that do you get your powers from eating snacks?
All of them, because I'm a raccoon.
Good. And what
that and that and my god, the snack giver. Who may or may not just be a really old guy who likes to feed the wildlife around Eugene.
What's funny
and that the raccoons... Oh, sorry, what?
No, I'm just saying, what's funny is Prom's motorcycle is called Snack Catcher.
Oh, we gotta do something about that.
Wait, what?
Your motorcycle is called Snack Catcher.
For what? For humans?
I don't know, that's what you named it.
Oh, yeah, for eating humans.
With the rocket launcher on it.
Is it bad that I was expecting... Mr. Pickles to eat one of the roaches?
I thought about it, but I was too busy dealing with the possible nuclear meltdown.
Oh, okay.
Survival kind of takes precedence at that point.
Look, I saw there were snacks on the ground, and I thought, you know who would love snacks? Swindle.
Also, one of them bit me, so it gave me a radiation sickness. I don't think eating one would do me any good.
All I'm hearing is cause for revenge, and by revenge I mean eating them. Sometimes to prove your superiority.
Just need to take a minute and smell the roses you dig. Let's close our eyes and think of America slapping its big dick all over those commie bastards.
Yes.
I fucking forgot about the sea lions.
Sea lions?
Yeah. So Portland has a big. Like, real life, Portland has a big sea lion population.
Oregon
so naturally,
does, yeah.
Yeah, so naturally we made them mutants.
They have a hipster infestation too.
And there's this scary kind of mutants because they fucking, they're able to run inland and they have a venomous bite. forget what else we gave them, but they're very aggressive and predatory.
So we have problems.
I mean, it's Fallout. We can't not have dangerous wildlife. Oh, I don't like that one at all. I like the first one better.
Do you remember the turkey you fought?
Oh, right, the turkeys. Jesus Christ.
What the fuck are you making?
We had some interesting times.
It was the Thanksgiving one, so they were fighting the turkey. Yeah. They had laser beam eyes.
Also, when you first came in, you saw all those frog bits and pieces. Yeah, that was us too.
I kind of assumed the wake of death behind you, beyond, that we walked past, was all you.
Yeah, it was great.
And then there was the Liberty bot that they had and then took apart.
Yep. And that's also where I got my Tesla gun, which is covered in communist symbols. And I had to...
You sound very Liberty.
Yeah, well, we found Liberty bot in a vault, and then the gun was being held by a corpse that was covered in Soviet symbols. So, like, the bunker was raided, I guess, before the bombs went off. Or maybe during.
That doesn't sound very freeing.
Well, the Liberty bot definitely didn't think so when I shot it with the gun.
It sounds like somebody took its freedom away.
Yeah, something like that. We also beat it, reprogrammed it, and then, like, took it apart. It was great. Oh, yeah, Mr. Pickles was eaten by the frog. I remember that.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that one.
Yeah, I was eaten by one. I had to, like, shoot my way out of it.
That is horrifying.
It was. I think that was the closest to dying that Mr. Pickles got.
I mean, juggling the dynamite was also kind of close.
Oh, yeah, that too. I forgot about that. I got to brush up on getting weird in Portland. But yeah, that was fun. I'm really liking Foundry.
Once you get that, so you can do stuff quickly in it. I hate having to take 5 minutes to fix something.
Yeah.
Like, especially the images, because in Roll20 you can just drag drop it and it'll pop up. But in this one I have to, like, copy over into the directory and then go in through here and change the scene background and whatnot. Because you can set up a bunch of different scenes, but I don't think it's really intended to really want you to do it that way.
Yeah. Alright, well, I'm gonna hop out here for a bit. Gotta finish up some laundry.
I got nothing better to do right now, but I am gonna hope for the next rounds of Blood Bowl so I can bother Alan for a match.
Oh yeah, this one's Drake played the game yet.
I don't think he can do the match.
He said to me,